Hello friends, now we see the problem number 2, which is also based on first principle of derivative of chapter derivative. Now problem number 2 is fx is equal to x root x, and question is we have to find derivative by using first principle. Now let's see the solution. First of all, we write fx is equal to x into root x. The next step is f of x plus h, that is equal to x plus h into square root of x plus h. Next step is by first principle of derivative. We have formula that f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus fx whole thing divided by h. Now substituting the values, we get limit h tends to 0 x plus h into square root of x plus h minus x into root x and then totally divide by h. Here we have radical part in the numerator, so that's why we have to rationalize the numerator. So on rationalizing, numerator the next step is limit h tends to 0 x plus h into square root of x plus h minus x root x in one bracket, then x plus h into square root of x plus h plus x root x in second bracket totally divided by h into x plus h into square root of x plus h plus x root x, and finally the bracket complete. So now your numerator is of the type a minus b and a plus b, where a represent x plus h into root x plus h and b represent here x root x. So applying that formula, a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. So here we get limit h tends to 0 x plus h into square root of x plus h whole bracket square minus x into root x whole bracket square upon h into bracket x plus h into square root of x plus h plus x root x, and finally the bracket complete. On simplifying further, we get limit h tends to 0. Now here if you open the bracket, so we get x plus h the whole square. At the same time, square root of x plus h whole square gives again x plus h. So totally here we get x plus h cube minus x root x the whole square gives us x cube, and that upon h into in bracket x plus h into square root of x plus h plus x root x. Now in the numerator, we apply the formula a plus b whole cube, and that gives us a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. So here we have x cube plus 3x square h plus 3x x square plus h cube, and then minus x cube we write as it is, totally divided by h in bracket x plus h into square root of x plus h plus x root x. Now here plus x cube and minus x cube we cancel in the numerator, and from the remaining terms we take h common. So the next step will be limit h tends to 0, 3 in bracket. So here we cancel plus x cube and minus x cube from numerator. The next step will be is equal to limit h tends to 0, 3 x square h plus 3 x x square plus h cube, totally divided by h into in bracket x plus h into square root of x plus h plus x root x, and finally the square bracket is complete. So the next step will be limit h tends to 0. Now in numerator we take h common, so h in bracket we have 3 x square plus 3 x h plus h square, and the bracket complete. Whole thing divided by h into in bracket we have x plus h into square root of x plus h plus x root x. Now here we cancel h from numerator and denominator, stating reason that since h tends to 0, provided h not equal to 0. It means we cancel h from numerator and denominator. So the next step will be limit h tends to 0, 3x square plus 3xh plus x square, totally divided by x plus h into square root of x plus h plus x root x. Now here we substitute limit as h equal to 0. So the next step will be is equal to 3x square plus 3x into 0 plus 0 square upon x plus 0 into square root of x plus 0 plus x root x. So that equal to, in the numerator we have only 3x square plus 3x into 0 0 plus 0 square 0, and in the denominator we have x into root x plus x into root x. On further simplifying we get 3x square upon 2x root x. Now we cancel x from numerator and denominator, so we left with 3x upon 2 root x. Now in the numerator we split x as a root x into root x upon 2 into root x in the denominator, and that equal to, again we cancel root x from numerator and denominator, so finally we left with 3 by 2 into root x. So therefore f dash x is equal to 3 upon 2 into root x. So this is a required solution for the given problem. Thank you.